What is up, everybody? Tegan here with High Point. Thanks for tuning in. William Optics just released their RedCat61 refractor. It's up on our website, it's live, and it's ready for pre-order. So let's go ahead and take a little dive into what this telescope may offer. So as you can see, it looks like the standard William Optics red color. You have the dovetail bar, you have the handlebar, the rotator, you have a tilt adapter, all standard for the RedCats, but there is a major difference, and that is the focuser. As you can see, this has an internal focus design, like unlike the RedCat 51, which has the helical design, and you can see that on the 71 as well. The RedCat 61 has an internal focus design, which is compatible with the ZWO EAF. This is going to prevent you from having to buy a third-party adapter to work with that helical focuser. So let's go and look at some of the specifications of the actual scope. It looks like it comes with the standard soft carrying case that we all love. These are great for traveling. With the 51 and the 71, they're small, they're compact. It's gonna be the same with the 61, so that's really exciting. And down here, we get a little bit better picture. It just looks sleek. It has these nice dovetail rings with the knobs. It's a pretty cool design. As far as the specs go, it's a 61 millimeter refractor, so just a little bit bigger than the RedCat 51. So you're gonna get about 10 more millimeters of light gathering power and a tad bit of added resolution. The focal length is 300 millimeters, making this a focal ratio of f4.9. Now, since we are talking focal lengths, let's take a look at the differences between the field of view of the RedCat 71 and the RedCat 61. If you take a look at this graphic here, this is a photo of the Veil Nebula taken with the RedCat 71. Now, if you look on the outside of that field of view, you see arrows pointing outwards. That would be the field of view of the RedCat 61. Now, the difference here isn't huge, but if you are trying to frame a rather large nebula or a galaxy, this increased field of view is definitely going to be noticeable. The RedCat 51 is also an f4.9, but it's a 250 millimeter scope, so you get 50 more millimeters of focal length with the new 61 design. Again, it does have a full frame imaging circle, so if you put that on your QH wire, your ASI 6200 full frame camera, it's going to correct really nicely for full frame cameras. Again, it's compatible with 2-inch filters, and the weight of this scope is 5.4 pounds with the OTA alone, and it looks like the dovetail and the saddle, the rings and everything added to it, it's going to be 7.47 pounds, which brings me to my next point. This is good for like a star tracker. If you just switch from like a camera lens and you want to get a dedicated telescope, a star tracker like the Skywatcher GTI is going to be fantastic for this. It's going to pair really well with the RedCat 61. Even if you go with the Skywatcher Star Venturer, it should be able to handle the weight of the RedCat 61. So all in all, it looks very promising. There's not much more information other than what we have been given here. So yes, we will do a full review of this product, so make sure you subscribe and like this video, and make sure that if you have any questions, comment. We'll be more than happy to assist. Thanks so much for tuning in, and clear skies.